Moin! In this electroplating special, we are diving into the metal coating of Warhammer 40k miniatures. I'll show how I prep the figures and then apply thick layers of copper and gold plating. This process makes them heavier and allows for irresistible metallic accents or even full armor plating, perfect as a base for painting. Are you ready? Let's do it! It's been requested a lot, hence a special episode. And this time we're not starting with a 3D print, but directly with the molds, which should be assembled beforehand. I wouldn't necessarily say that electroplating miniatures is better than painting, it's simply a different approach. And whether it's worth the effort is up to each person to decide. Generally, if possible, you should coat the models as a whole. Sure, you can mask off specific areas, but acrylic paint adheres fantastically to the metal, so why not? Definitely make sure to remove those mold lines and glue the parts together properly, not as amateurishly as I'm doing here. Electroplating emphasizes every flaw and really brings out details. Alright, so I'm not using paints to create metallic areas, instead I'm applying a conductive paint to deposit metal atoms onto it. Typically I use copper paint, which can be hard to find outside the EU, so sometimes I also show graphite paint. You can make it yourself, it's a bit trickier but achieves the same result. I'll link my video on mixing it up. In any case, I use a 0.5mm airbrush to apply it to the miniatures. But before we get started, it's time for the PPE show. Really, I protect myself from all the fumes and chemicals as best as I can. Gloves are essential, along with goggles for splashes and a respirator that I wear throughout. My clothes matter to me, so I wear lab coat. I also work in a well-ventilated area. Now I'm spraying several light layers of the conductive paint directly onto the model. I make sure to cover all areas and ensure it's not applied too thinly. This is important, don't spray too thinly. Ideally, this thin conductive layer should be even and smooth. Let it dry thoroughly, preferably for a few hours. Before we start, let's measure the weight. It's 5.6 grams. So, now to what you're probably here for, the electroplating. Typically, I work with 3D prints like this kit card from Agatbis. The electroplating process creates such a thick layer around the print that it becomes very rigid and inflexible. At the same time, as mentioned, it also highlights the layer or mold lines. Keep that in mind. For electroplating, I need the following items and I'll go over each one in detail. Let's start with the electrolytes. Here I have 5 liters of acidic bright copper electrolyte with a pH of around 1. I've been using it for years and it regenerates and is well maintained. You'll need a container such as a 1 liter one or even better, a 4 liter vat. Next, I use nickel electrolyte to create a barrier layer for the gold. This is incredibly nasty stuff that prevents mixing the metals to rosé gold, though you could also use much milder palladium instead. Lastly, here's the gold electrolyte, which is used at the very end. This litter costs around 190 euros and should never come into contact with acid. That's why I rinse it with distilled water. My power supply for this electrochemistry is a simple lab power supply that can regulate voltage. I use it in constant current mode and don't bother with the voltage at all. I use copper wire to attach the objects connecting the negative pole of the power supply to these. With a thinner wire, I try to make light contact with the conductive copper layer at as many points as possible. The positive pole is connected to the anodes. An electric field is created between these and the cathode, the workpiece, which allows the material to deposit onto the conductive layer. Each electrolyte requires its own anode, copper for the copper electrolyte, nickel for the nickel electrolyte, and I use stainless steel for the gold electrolyte. The latter, however, does not regenerate the electrolyte. Blah, 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 blah. Just get started already. Okay, we're starting with copper. So, connect the power supply's positive pole to the anode. I'll hang it here on one side. You can also use two on both sides, which can lead to more even results. Now I attach the thick wire to the miniature and wrap the thin wire around it so it contacts different spots. I'm careful not to damage the lacquer layer. Then I attach the wire to the negative pole cable and place the whole setup attached to my rotor jig in the electrolyte. By the way, the conductive paint only becomes conductive now. A special on rotation devices is coming soon, I swear. So set the current and, hey, wait a minute, how much current should actually flow? To calculate that, I need the surface area of the miniature. So I thought doing some 3D scanning with some apps for my face idea sensor would be a good idea. Nope, that wasn't working. Anyway, I ended up guessing by comparing it to similar miniatures I knew the surface area. The formula is 1 amp per square decimeter. With that, you will have a deposition rate of 0.5 millimeters per minute. After 4 hours, I take them out one by one. That was a total of 20 hours for 5 pieces. Generally, I didn't need any buffing here. The gloss additive in my electrolyte and the even lacquer layer made it possible. You could almost leave it as it is, right? Well, if you ever need a copper base, any ideas? I go ahead and weigh it. 7.7 grams, that's a 37% weight increase, and you can definitely feel it. Before we move on to golding, I want to take a moment to thank my channel members. Thank you for supporting this little hobby channel. I've printed and electroplated small medals with your names on them, and I'm hanging them up in my workshop. And thanks for all the comments, subs and likes everybody leaves. This helps me a lot. Thank you. Alright, now let's move on to the nickel plating. As mentioned, nickel plating should be done with extra caution. I go full PPE on this. I hang a nickel anode in the nickel electrolyte and set the power supply to constant voltage. Nickel oxidizes pretty quickly, so the anode may need to be activated with an activator. Right after copper plating, I take the piece and rinse it in distilled water to prepare it optimally. Now I dip it into the nickel electrolyte and rotate it for about 2 minutes. The nickel deposits quickly and afterwards I rinse again in distilled water. As I said, an alternative here is palladium, which is much nicer. I quickly blow dry the miniature and repeat this process with the remaining figures. At this point, I have a nice silvery Adeptus Custodes group. With other miniatures, I could stop here and paint them. They look great. You know what I do with all the leftover electrolytes? I collect them in containers and take them to the recycling center. Responsibility, right? Gold is relatively easy. Basically, just like before, constant voltage and then follow the instructions at around 3 to 4 volts for gilding. It only takes a few seconds. Rinse and voila! Now the question, can you still paint these well? Yes, definitely. A bit of acrylic paint on top sticks like a charm. Good to have that cleared up. I've also printed a nice box. They are all going in there, and then I actually want to gift them to Henry Cavill. He can test if the paint really holds up. No joke. So, what do you think? Good idea or maybe a bit too much effort? Go gentle on me, I just wanted to show that it works pretty smoothly with great results. Leave a comment, I'll definitely read it. Cheers!